And yes, I do have Nunzio again. Like that? No. But hey, get choked, do they? Well, at least I'm on top, but this... I do not like close matches, people. Well, I hope this video is a lot better. The background noise should be a whole lot better. You don't hear a computer in the background as like you used to. And you know what? What I don't understand from YouTube is how come we can't see our comments after the video was produced. GC?
Here. Alright, and then we'll rub the stage here. Before the vote, we'll get a band everyone likes, like...
Toto.
Like Toto. And then the Harbucks guy will have 5 minutes to speak, and the boys will have 5 minutes to speak, and then the town votes.
Boy, you better get your asses to work.
Right now!
They're expecting you to give a big speech on corporate takeovers, and this time it has to last 5 minutes.
Oh, God! When is this gonna end? Your dad really screwed us, Twink. He's sued. I'm to blame for all this! I'm to blame for everything!
Heavy
ammo. So what are we gonna say? Why can't we just read the paper we wrote last time? Because then they'll know we didn't write it, dummy. We have to be original. Does anybody know anything about corporations? Wait, I think my mom is a corporation. Yeah, that makes sense. You guys! Well, how about we just say corporate chili stuff? And then we'll stretch that into 5 minutes.
We were taking underpants!
Yeah, will you stop with the underpants notes, Tweak? We have to work here.
Yeah, give me a second.
Don't scare him. Hey there, little guy.
Bad. You left again.
Carmen, why do you always have to hit stuff with a stick? Look at him.
Is that all you got, pussy?
What? Hey, Tom. Yeah, he called me a pussy. I'm not a pussy. You're a pussy.
You're a pussy.
Hey, dude, why are you taking Tweak's underpants? Yeah, look what you're doing to this poor kid.
Underpants.
Business? Wait, do you know anything about business?
Sure, that's what gnomes do.
Show us.
I'll tell you, follow me.
You're a pussy gnome. Don't call me a pussy. Pussy gnome.
Not much longer now.
Are you taking it to your little pussy house?
No, pussy, I'm taking it to my village.
Hey, pussy daddy. Carmen, will you just shut up and let him show us?
I don't know.
I hope we're not wasting our time with this little packer.
All right, boys, that's it. Pack it up. We're moving out of town.
Oh, but we just finished.
I know, but these folks obviously don't want us here.
But what will become of us?
Oh, quit being so melodramatic, Sanchez. Jesus Christ.
Damn, dude, this place is huge. Yeah, it's almost as big as Carmen's ass. No, it isn't.
It is. This is where all our work is done.
So what are you going to do for these underpants pieces?
Collect and pull them from just phase one. Phase one, collect underpants.
So what's phase two?
Are you finally back?
Who?
Uh-oh.
Phase two. Phase one, we collect underpants.
We have no idea what's going on with Nunzio. Stand by, people. Stand by.
Underpants.
Heavy ammo available.
What the hell happened? That was weird. Oh, hopefully you get...
Toto, ladies and gentlemen!
Yeah, Toto! Woo! Toto!
Woo! All right.
Quiet there, wee crew.
...on Prop 10, here to remind us why are the lovable, innocent children.
Since we are so concerned with the corporate takeovers, we went and asked our friends the Underpants Gnomes, and they told us all about big corporations.
Underpants Gnomes?
Big corporations are good.
Only 5 minutes left.
Good?
Because without big corporations, we wouldn't have things like cars and computers and cans. Even Harvest Coffee started off as a small little business, but because it made such great coffee, and because they ran their business so well, they managed to grow until
it's a good thing you haven't come back yet, because I'm on top with points. People we're with are kind of, heh.
That's not what you said last time.
It's okay.
Well, the truth is, we didn't write that paper last time.
You little turd! You ruined my life for the last time!
Grenade.
We're as low and despicable as Rob Reiner. You keep protesting and complaining, but did any of you ever even bother to taste Starbucks coffee?
No, I have comments on my YouTube video of my Minecraft. Yeah, and after the stream's done, there were comments added.
It doesn't have that bland, raw sewage taste.
Why don't I see them? That's the question, YouTube. Why can't we see our comments after they're uploaded? I invited you. Check your invites.
No, we still need someone to run this Harbucks Coffee House. I'm sure we'll make a lot of money.
Thank you, Mr. Poston, but I think we'll be fine with the...
Let me finish it.
Just kidding, son.
We're gonna lose this one anyway. Just hold on. Excuse me. Jeez. Heavy ammo.
Available.
It's because of Jessica's, Can you hear it now? That's just a little background noise, people. Just my wife waiting to my daughter, so don't worry about it. Riku, hush!
We're just being ourselves.
Oh my god, we're winning. Come on! Yes, we won! Woo! All right, what a comeback! Oh boy, that was a good match. Poor Nunzio, he got kicked out. He would have had a good one. I didn't finish on top though.
Go, go, go!
I'm gonna jam my thumb in its butthole, man. This should really piss it off.
people are in LA go la 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 la. Nickelodeon. Oh God. Arrive and be quiet.
Where should we bring it? I don't know. We just have to get it to town and then let them figure out what to do with it. I think I'm gonna name it Gorak. No, dude, we have to name it Steve. Steve, without kind of Steve. It's my name, and I found him. You didn't find him, I found him. What are you talking about, dude?
Excuse me. Shut up, dear fool.
Question.
Yippee! All those opposed say nay.
Nay!
Screw you! Hey, screw you!
Excuse me. Not now, kids. The town is having a very important debate on capital punishment.
But we found a frozen Iceman from the past! I found this frozen guy in the woods today. No, I found this frozen guy in the woods today.
What the hell is going on here?
We came for a reward. Yeah, like a kid with a wallet.
Reward? What reward?
Mayor, I think the boys may have stumbled onto something here. You see, Mayor, frozen links are often found. Dinosaur eggs, woolly mammoths. This specimen could be a missing link in our evolution. If I can unfreeze the body and perform an autopsy, I could learn much about the
Iron Banner.
But it's time.
It is Iron Banner.
Knock your socks off.
Thank you, Mayor. Oh, and boys, I can't give you a reward.
God, GC, you're...
But if you'd like...
You name him. Really? Sweet. How about Steve?
Steve it is.
No, we're not. This is different.
Steve, we've got work to do. Unfreezing this body will be quite delicate work. We'll have to use the most advanced methods available. This is very exciting.
You better start gaining points, boy. I got 200. What is wrong with Raikou Riven? Well, don't make him bleed!
What about the prehistoric
Iceman?
Oh, yeah,
there
is that. Dr. Mephesto, could you please tell us what's going on?
Ladies and gentlemen, we still have a lot of work to do. But it is my opinion that this man has been frozen in time for over 30
years. Oh, come on!
This is true. Although at this early stage, we know very little about this man or the time from which he comes.
Fascinating news tonight from South Park. An ancient discovery of a prehistoric man actually frozen in ice. A team of scientists continues to freeze the body so that it can be autopsied and studied. The caveman was discovered by Karl Poplowski, who had this to say.
Well, I fell down this ice cavern.
The prehistoric Iceman is thought to be from the late
Great, I need that hookup.
Where he was probably part of a hunting and gathering tribe that lived on Waterston Street.
I can't. She's in the room with the kid.
That's it, Kevin. Now we can begin the autopsy. What's this?
Holy crap, he's alive?
That's impossible. Do an EKG on him.
Oh! My God, he's alive. E-grenade. Baby. How is this with 5 minutes left? That?
Where am I?
What?
What's inside?
What, Angus?
What? You're hungry?
Where am I?
You're hungry?
What's going on?
Me, friend. Friend.
Ah, what the?
My best dog.
What the douche?
My best dog. Huh? If we can understand what he's saying.
You keep dying, don't you, James?
If only there was someone who could communicate with him on a level as primitive as his own. A mind like a child.
Dude, I wanted to call
Gorak. Gorak. I'm gonna fly like...
Why are you being such a dick? I'm not being a dick, you're being a dick.
Hello, children. Dr. Mephesto needs one of you to help him out in his lab with the prehistoric Iceman.
I'll go. No, I'll go. I found him. Damn, I've never seen you guys fight like this.
All right, there's only one fair way to do this. Everyone stick out their potatoes. My brother and your brother were out case close. My brother punched your brother in the nose. What color blood came out?
Oh.
B-L-O-O-O spells blue, and that means that you will go to the lab and help out Mephesto, and then we can all go.
They're camping for the heavy ammo.
Steve, you.
Where am I?
Steve. Oh, good, you're here.
Oh, my God. There we go, it's Gorak. You found him.
Yes, and I need you to communicate with him. See if you can understand what he's saying.
Hi.
What'd he say?
He said hi.
Very interesting.
What? He wants to know where he is.
Tell him he's home.
You're home.
In the year 1999.
It's 1999?
He's been frozen for the past 32 months.
Dude, you've been frozen for 32 months.
And we found you.
What? 32 months?
All right, calm down.
Come on, the same guy?
Dude, you freaked him out. Oh, shut up, Adam.
He's camping it.
Guess what? You're not my best friend anymore. Carmen's my new best friend.
Me?
Oh, yeah? Well, you're not my best friend anymore either. Carmen is now my best friend.
Yeah.
Fine. Me?
Heavy ammo available.
Yeah, see the cats for it. Cheating. Sorry, we claimed it before they could touch it. No, we claimed it before they took it.
Child, he's not just a child. The young Messiah, rated PG-13.
Stark Iceman from 1996.
That's right.
We would like to... We would like to offer our services in your experiments.
Oh, where are you gents from?
From the University
of America.
Well, there's not a lot to see, but come on in. He's still not responding much to us. The shock is still settling.
This is the worst game that I've ever rejoined.
Yes, Kevin and I designed a habitat for Steve.
Most people by now.
Everything is 1996 oriented.
So much like us.
Yes, well, Kevin has done a lot of work in figuring out just how related to us Steve really is. He came up with this drawing.
Dr. Mephesto, we realize that scientific study is expensive. We want to help you make this project more lucrative.
How would we do that?
It's easy.
As you can see, the Iceman is listening to Ace of Base, which was a very popular group during his era. Their primitive drumming soothes his people's tempers.
He doesn't look very happy in there.
No, he sure doesn't.
I wasn't talking to you, Bud Pie, but I was talking to Cartman.
Well, I was talking to Cartman, too.
Yeah, that's pretty freaking cool, all of a sudden.
Here we see the Iceman trying to gain internet access on the computer. The internet was still not very big at his time, so the web frightened
him. Yeah, they're copying the ammo.
He can't even see us. And now the Iceman watches television.
This grizzly bear has the strength of over 10 Morgan Freemans. I'm really pissing him off right now.
Wait, this could be dangerous. Also, he's changing the channel. Something on the television could frighten and confuse him.
And
don't do anything.
The Atlanta Falcons.
Falcons are going to
just stand.
What?
Let it run out.
Seconds remaining.
Don't fight the people that rather sit and wait for the dams. Only the strong have ammo and can't buy it instead of playing the game right. I'm not saying with that group.
Hey, kids, could you just open the door so I can get back to my family?
I found him. I'm rescuing him.
Thanks.
You're a dick. And I've had it with your dicketry. I choose you. You want to fight? That's fine with me. Tomorrow afternoon at the bus stop, 4 o'clock. Why don't we make it 3 o'clock?
Because 2 turns 4 was on 3.
Oh, yeah. Fine. I'll kick your ass tomorrow, dick. I'll kick your ass so bad you wish you never had it to begin with.
My discipline is tier 5. Tier 5. We deaf?
He's gone. The Iceman has broken out.
Let Mark know.
He must have used this door. Damn it, damn it. We have to find him. He won't survive long out in the world.
Yes, and if he isn't found, we're going to be able to use
my discipline is 308. Tier 5 material. For discipline.
Dr. Mephisto, where could the creature have gone?
No! Discipline!
Never track him down on our own. This calls for some special assistance.
Can I help you?
Leslie, it's me, Larry. Your husband?
Husband? You're not my husband.
Think hard, Leslie. We used to be together for over 8 years.
I seem to remember a husband, but I think he was lost and never found on Kenosha Pass.
That was me!
Oh.
Who is it, lover?
It's my former husband who I'd forgotten all about.
Ooh. Well, sir, let me shake your hand. I'm proud to meet the man whose wife I'm currently sticking to every night. So you remarried?
Yes, Lori.
Larry?
Larry. Larry, you disappeared. I waited for you to come home for over 3 days. I remember how cold and lonely the nights got. By the fourth day, I knew I had to move on.
Didn't anybody send out a search party for me?
We did, Larry. We looked all afternoon, but we found nothing. No trace.
Please, Leslie, I don't know where else to go.
So, Mark, get a look of it?
You're Leslie.
Right. I'm with Buck now. We have children together. Calvin is 8 and little.
That my discipline's that high?
I can't just up and leave them. I'm sorry.
We joined into another one. It's Clash. Ridiculous, ridiculous. I figure that was crap because they have a guy, one more guy more than we do.
I'm freezing myself again.
Wow, that sucks, dude.
Tell me about it.
Which is very agitated.
Only my toes are starting to ice over.
Agitating.
What are you doing here, Dick? We're not supposed to fight until 4 o'clock. I've got something to show Steve, Dick. Gorak is busy freezing himself again, Dick. Steve, you don't have to freeze yourself.
Yeah, but this is a map that's very hard to get to it, back to it, because you gotta circle around.
Oh,
shit. Oh! No, 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 no!
Oh,
Man down.
You're going to Des Moines.
Oh, no, you don't, Glorymonger. Gorak is my responsibility. I'll take him to Des Moines.
No, you won't, butthole.
They're coming for me.
Come on.
Was the Iceman here?
He might have been, by Cracky.
We have to get him back. Well, can you do it?
Sure, I can. I can hunt down anything.
Wow, kick ass!
What is that in the background? Yours? God dang it! There's a 40 watching for heavy. Right here.
We need a one-way ticket to Des Moines, please.
Des Moines? What the hell for?
We have to get our friend Steve,
my friend Gorak,
to Des Moines, or else he's gonna melt away.
No, he's not gonna melt away. That's Frosty, you stupid butthole.
Frosty, Steve, whatever.
Well, okay, I'll find him a seat.
Dude, look, it's 4 o'clock. Oh, we'll wait for you over there, Steve. We have to start fighting now.
Okay, boys, thanks.
Okay, first one to die loses. Okay.
Heavy ammo.
Okay.
Punch him.
Okay. So here we go. Okay. Go.
Heavy ammo available.
Wait a second.
I think he came through here recently.
Yeah, I think the same thing.
Well, where the hell is he? We've got to get him back to the lab.
He can't function out here in our time.
Calm down, calm down.
Yeah, calm down, calm down, you touch bitches.
Wait, look. Is it him?
Nah, it's a Rocky Mountain rattlesnake. This is the most poisonous snake in this entire region.
So what I'm going to do is carefully sneak up on him and jam my thumb in its butthole.
Cracking! Oh, this snake is really pissed! I'm gonna jam my thumb in its butt on him! Oh, yeah, that pissed it over, alright! Does he always do this?
Yeah.
I'm gonna go jam my thumb in his butt on him! Ow! Ow! What's my coat, dude? Oh!
I got my coat.
Huh?
I have to go to platform B.
Oh, okay, it's going this way.
The trial ends here. The train station? Then he's trying to go somewhere.
Have you seen a man who looks similar to us, but with a thicker brow and apish nose?
What the hell are you talking about?
An Iceman. A man from the past. We must find him. Now, where is he?
Well, this is it. I'm going back to my time. Thanks again, boys.
No problem, Clark. Later.
You boys have really shown me the true meaning of friendship. You didn't care about anything but my happiness. You put me in front of yourselves, and that's what real friendship is all about.
Yep, uh-huh.
After being frozen, I've learned that all a person has in life is family and friends. If you lose those, you have nothing. So friends are to be treasured more than anything else in the world.
Bye-bye.
Watching the heavy ammo that's up here.
It's not stopping!
We already collected it.
Why
Yes, we did. No, it was never collected. That's not fair. I got killed. You ask the person in your background to turn that down. Calm down. Cause you gotta show yourself in a different way.
I can't believe he's gone. Who is gone? The helicopter! He's alive!
Goodbye again! I'm off to Des Moines!
No, come back! You can't adapt! You'll never live!
I'm not living here! Living is having ups and downs and sharing them with friends! Thank you, Stan and Kyle! See ya!
Dad, well, so much for our plan to use the Iceman to take over Sweden.
What?
What? Nothing.
Steve is a pretty good name for that guy. No, dude, Gorak is cool because it's original. And besides, you found him.
Be very, very quiet. I'm hunting crocodiles.
Can we be best friends again?
I hate having Carmen as a best friend.
Me too. He sucks.
Oh, yeah? Well, I don't need you guys anyway. You guys can kiss my... Aha! There's a croc right there!
New Gatlins!
And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sneak up.
Ooh.
And jam my...
Got train coins. Baby, baby, ooh, baby, baby. Baba baby. Excuse me. Say no. But I farted. Yeah.
Only for mature audiences. Viewer discretion advised.
Feel alive.
Before and after Modern Family on ABC.
We're getting a divorce.
I'm anorexic.
I'm gay.
What?
I think Kenny said he's gay. Do you want this open or closed?
Reality is two episodes premiere Wednesday before and after Modern Family on ABC.
Okay, children, we have a special guest today, a woman recruiting young people for a national choir tour. Now, I know that choir tours are totally stupid and lame, but please give her your full attention. Go ahead.
Thank you, Mr. Garrison. How are we all doing today? I can't hear you. I said, how are we all doing?
Hey, Cartman, you say excuse me.
Okay.
Go ahead.
Children, we are a national choir called Getting Gay with Kids. We're going to do a big tour down in Central America to help save the rainforest, and you can be a part of it.
Getting Gay with Kids?
Hey, McCormick, you speak when you're spoken to!
Hello?
Put them in a choir where we sing and dance to raise awareness about our vanishing rainforest.
No, over 10,000 acres of rainforest are bulldozed.
That's right, and over 30% of the
what the hell are you doing?
Rainforest. So who wants to join the fun?
What if you don't have any rhythm?
Excuse me?
Like my friend Kyle, he's Jewish, so he doesn't have any rhythm.
Why'd you mute yourself, you fool?
Really, so if anyone is interested in joining us, I'll leave information packets up front.
Yay! I got to hold it!
stick together, team.
And you get sent here every day, Craig.
I don't.
Why can't you behave?
I don't know.
What do you have to say for yourself? Well, I tell you, you're gonna be held back, Craig, if you don't look... Did you just flip me off?
No.
Yes, you did. You just flipped me the bird. Now, see, this is exactly what I'm talking about. If you don't shape up, okay, and get your head straight, then... Oh, you just flipped me off again.
No, I didn't.
Camping.
And until you stop flipping people off, you can just go back to the waiting room. Okay, next. Well, if it isn't Stan, Kyle, Kenny, and Eric.
Hey, Craig. Hey, don't flip me off, you son of a bitch.
Sit down, boys. Now, let's see. What did Mr. Garrison send you in here for? The boys were being rude while a choir teacher was giving some stupid presentation.
It's just some dumb activist kids choir thing.
You're running like puss.
It's not dumb, okay? It just so happens that I'm on the board.
Yeah, they're hiding.
The choirs are the same. They don't even really sing. They use pre-recorded tapes.
Well, guess what, boys? I think that getting good with kids is just what you need. I'm gonna sign up all four of you.
What?
It's because they're scared.
Oh, I think this will be very good for you.
But we don't even care about the rainforest.
And that's exactly why you need to go, okay?
Please, Mr. Maggot, we'll be good. Don't send us an old kid clock. Have mercy, Mr. Maggot.
Be safe, Kyle. Bring me something back from the rainforest.
Oh, no. The rainforest is very fragile. We must take only pictures and leave. Only the
he can't twist chains.
Bulldozers are tearing down dozens of acres of rainforest every day.
Aw, man, this is gonna suck, doggy bars. Please don't make me go to fire for him, Mom, please. Stan, you should be excited. I would love to see the rainforest. Besides, your dad and I need some time alone.
No!
We're ready to head for the Latin American nation of Costa Rica, a country filled virgin rainforest. And you must be Eric Cartman. I've heard about you. You don't respect nature or other cultures.
Yeah, pretty much.
Well, I'm going to change the way you think, kiddo.
My name's Kelly.
Woo woo.
Lenny?
Woo woo.
Johnny?
Sally!
Oh, now we've got a long trip ahead of us, so let's take the opportunity to learn our choreography.
The nightmare begins.
Oh, look, children, I think we're entering San Jose, which is the capital of Costa Rica. Oh, this is so exciting.
Oh my gosh, it is like getting crappy everything is.
Eric? Costa Rica is a third world country. These people are much poorer than those in the
States. Yeah, they're starting it.
Why don't you people quit slacking off and get
hold on, James.
You go to college.
Eric, sit down.
Look, you gotta be fair with these people. They just slack off and be poor forever, right, Kenny? Hey, maybe that's it, Kenny. Maybe you're Costa Rican. That's why your family's so poor. Your family isn't poor? Whoa, dude, look over there. Wow, Costa Rican prostitutes. Hey, look at the prostitutes, you guys.
Why don't you take a picture?
Okay.
Kids, this is the Costa Rican Capitol building. This is where all the leaders of the Costa Rican government make their...
Oh my god, it smells like Amazon now.
All right, that does it. Eric Cartman, you respect other cultures this instant.
I wasn't saying anything about their culture. I was just saying their city smells like ass.
Wow, staying in a place like this really makes you appreciate living in America, huh?
Uh-huh. You may think that making fun of third world countries is funny, but let's
not think it's funny. This place.
We can barely touch these guys. This is getting ridiculous.
Please just keep your mouth shut while we present ourselves to the Costa Rican president.
What?
They're gonna buy us some ice cream afterwards if you do. Well, it was a long trip, but the children are very excited to sing tomorrow.
We're
the choir that was sent from the United States. We're the group singing for the Saved Rainforest Summit tomorrow. Behind. Oh dear, where's Mr. Mackey? He should have been here by now. Children, do any of you speak Spanish?
Don't be scared.
Sorry, I'm late.
Oh, thank goodness you're here. I don't speak any Spanish.
Oh, no problem. Son of choir, dude. That is me, though.
Oh. Save the rainforest.
Yes.
Pablo los llevará en un tour de la jungla.
He says Pablo here will take you on a rainforest tour.
Oh, boy. Mr. Presidente, round up your subject.
No, we just got back the lead.
A special gift for you. The gift of song.
Okay.
All right, children, let's get in our row quickly so we can begin.
Did you remember all the choreography, Lenny?
Well, don't worry. Hello, everybody. This is just
a little rehearsal for tomorrow, so we may be a little rusty.
Don't stand in my discharge. Because they hide. Now it is.
Great job, gang. You were really all over the place, Kyle.
Thanks. I told you Jewish people don't have rhythm.
Fuck off, Carmen!
No, dude, I think Carmen might actually be right.
No, that's a stereotype, dude. Maybe you really don't have any rhythm.
This is now second lady. Great forest we are entering. Notice the canopy of foliage.
Oh, it's everything I ever dreamed it would be.
God damn it, hot out here. No, dude, that's a branch. No, that's the same branch again.
The rainforest is very delicate, and we must take steps to protect it.
Yeah, take this, we'll take it. That. We heard it a million times back up in the States.
Here, look, these are squirrel monkeys, endangered inhabitants of the rainforest.
Wow, isn't he neat, Lenny?
Harry, what the heck are you doing?
I'm asserting myself, it's tough love. Just like my Mitchell Kitty. When he's bad, I say, that's a bad Mitchell Kitty. I'll smack him on the head.
And here is a three-toed sloth.
It's back! And a bad three-toed sloth!
Harry, for God's sake, knock it off!
It's back now, daughter!
Well, Mr. Pedro, this was a great tour, but I guess we should be heading back. We have a big concert tomorrow, don't we, kids?
Yeah! I wish we could have seen the Yanagapa.
What's the Yanagapa?
The Yanagapa are gentle, native people that live in the rainforest, but bulldozers are destroying their homes. Soon they will have nowhere to go. So we must stop bulldozing the rainforest.
No, he runs. It's called They Don't Want to Die. They want a perfect game.
Oh, yes. This is what we call a coral snake. Notice the red markings.
This is bullcrap. We shouldn't have lost. People don't know.
Scared of snakes.
Nah, you must remember. This snake is more afraid of us than we are of it.
Oh, my God!
Yeah, that snake is really scared of us, all right.
Jesus Christ, is he dead?
Dude, my guess would be yes.
Oh, no, God, no. No, don't panic, children.
That's a bad snake.
Maybe we came from that way. No, let's try this way.
Benny, do you think we're gonna be okay?
Oh.
That's good. Can I tell you something?
Oh.
I think I like you.
What?
Yeah, I mean, I think we communicate really well. No, that's not good. No, see, if I start to like you too much, I'm only going to get my heart broken. Because we live on opposite ends of the country. Once this choir tour is over, we'll never see each other again. And that would devastate me. So I can't have any feelings for you. I just can't, Lenny.
Oh, children, the sun is setting. We have to find our way out of here quick.
See, where'd he go?
Okay, everything is just fine, kids. Now, it is important that we all stick together. Is everybody still here?
I'm not.
Who's not?
Mojo horses.
Benny, will you hold my hand? I don't want to get emotionally attached, though.
Oh, my God, dude. I just saw Tony Danza.
No, you couldn't just see Tony Danza, Stanley.
Bueno, pongan el arco iris al lado de las tortugas muertas.
Buenos días, señor presidente. Bien.
¿Qué tal? ¿Está todo bien?
Muy bien. Señor presidente, ¿usted no ha visto el corona? Bien.
¿Qué?
Parece que no.
¡Auch!
Regresaron al hotel. Bien.
¿Está bromeando, Maki? Más de 100,000 personas atenderán este evento. ¿Y me dice que no tendré a mis chiquitos lindos para que les canten?
Estoy seguro que... No soy pretty, but I'll be there, you know.
good.
Dude, we're totally lost. We're gonna die out here.
We are?
Don't worry, Kelly. We're gonna find our way out of the rainforest and make it back to the concert in time. We just need to respect our mother rainforest and she will respect us.
Mrs. Stevens, you have a bug on your back.
Oh, really? Could you brush it off?
No.
Children, we must understand that the insects of the rainforest help the delicate balance of life here.
Oh my god! Rainforest sucks. I want to go home.
Me too.
Children, okay, let's try to listen to what the rainforest tells us. And if we use our ears, she can tell us so many things.
Perhaps... there's a dude here!
Oh, thank goodness. Hello, sir. We are lost. Can you help us?
Okay.
Let me try. We are from America. America. We are lost and very hungry. Necesito burritos.
I don't want a burrito. I want a taco. Supreme.
A taco.
I want two tostadas and mild sauce.
Two tostadas and enchilada.
Boys, please. Not every Spanish person eats tacos and burritos. That's a stereotype. Children, he wants us to follow him. Oh, thank goodness. I think this ordeal is over.
Doesn't look very safe.
Yeah, I think we should get the hell out of here.
Now, kids, let's be a bit more open-minded. I've read all about this in Newsweek. This is a people's army. They are fighting the fascist policies of their fascist government. Oh, hello. Do you speak English?
Who are you?
Oh, wonderful. We were lost. What? It is such a great coincidence. We found you. You see, we're here to protest the government's...
Wow, good for you. That's ridiculous. How fair?
To San Jose?
Because she's a Mr. Loudmouth.
Oh, I know. Perhaps you would like a gift. Well, we have only one gift to give. The gift of song.
This is ridiculous, people. Yeah, let's go to Nunzio on YouTube. Because he's a big loudmouth. Why? Because people like loudmouths. Why? Because they think they're idiots. See, you rather watch someone that talks a lot on their YouTube channel when they're playing instead of quiet. Pretty neat. That's cute, people.
Because of the little Jewish boy's choreography?
You white Americans make me sick. You waste food, oil, and everything else because you're so rich and lean. You tell the rest of the world to save the rainforest because you lack its pretty power.
You're in the lead.
Rapido, rapido!
Run, children, run!
I'm really into this car, but how do I know if I'm getting a good deal? Truecar knows exactly how much people have been paying for the car I want. I tell Truecar my zip, what car I'm into, and it shows me the Truecar curve. It shows the range of prices people in my area actually paid for the same car. Looks like these folks paid a little more than everyone else. And this guy got the deal of a lifetime.
They got more than we do. That's not fair.
Behind.
The it's cheating.
Preparing at this very moment.
Oh, there's just no end to this place. I think maybe we're going in circles. Oh dear God, we're gonna start.
No.
Where are you going?
No, it's because they rather.
I say you
it's.
This place.
You can stay
but I'm going over.
9:30, so give it another hour, and these hardcore players are going to disappear.
Good. You deserve to die, you little bastard. Eric, we have to stay together.
Goddamn stupid heavy activist. I should be home nestled in the couch with my Rick and Katie right now watching Saturday cartoon things.
Maybe
Carmen was right. Yeah, it happened once before.
No, the spirit of Maya has told me to go this way.
Mister, you gotta help me. I'm starving to death.
What are you doing here, little boy?
I was with my class, and we got lost in the rainforest, and I need some food. I'm fading fast.
Lost in the rainforest? Oh, my lord. Where are all the others?
Food.
Oh, my God. Get this child some food, quick.
Chicken wings.
Chicken wings.
Medium spicy.
Start the show! Start the show!
Gente está ansiosa. Dentro de poco se alborotan y empiezan a tirar chochadas.
Estoy seguro que llegaron. Con solo un poquito más de tiempo, ¿bien?
Bueno, voy a entretenerlos con mis chistes de polacos.
Bien.
¿A cuántos polacos les toma comerse un burrito? Dos. ¿A cuántos polacos le toma manejar a Panamá?
Oh, God, this is a nightmare. We're never going to make the festival.
Hey, look over there. Isn't that smoke?
Let's go, quickly.
Hey, it's a fire. That means there must be people.
Children, it's the Yanaga Ball.
Where are you?
Do not be afraid. We are not
freaks.
Going to tear down your rainforest.
Dr. Lee.
Look how they live in peace with all of them.
James, you didn't protect me.
Okay, just what the heck is going on here, people?
Oh no, that big thing is going to make lots of McStevens.
All right, that does it.
Let's get stupid ass rainforest.
This place fucking sucks. I was wrong. Fuck the rainforest. I fucking hate it. I fucking hate it.
Oh, now she figures it out.
Jump a grenade. How?
There's a place called the Rainforest.
James, you.
Let's knock it all down and take
5 minutes remaining.
James!
But what do you know? You've never been to the Rainforest.
Stop muting your dang mic!
Cells. All you have to do is
boys and girls.
Huh. Ah, what the?
Getting gay with kisses here. Fuck our world and bring you cheer.
Yeah.
Getting gay with kisses here. Let's knock down the rainforest. What do you say? It's totally gay. It's totally gay.
No, this one we're getting pounded still.
My full name is Jason Alexander Lopez, so a lot of people will take me in their phone as George Costanza.
George Costanza!
Seinfeld on Hulu is an amazing thing, and I can watch it now and still laugh at the same jokes that I laughed at years ago when I first watched it. Some of my friends that I've met through watching the show and loving the show are now some of the closest people that I have in my life. Seinfeld lives in every aspect of my life. I love it.
I know that's not the best.
No one backs up the low level. It's over. Most hardcore gamers start leaving.
Is this what you're looking for, Kyle? No, I don't think so. No, that's a hairdryer.
Can I help you find something?
Yeah, do you have any erections?
Any what?
I need to get an erection for my dad.
Very funny, boys. Go on, beat it.
Why is that funny? Dude, my mom and dad keep fighting all the time, and I heard them say it's because my dad doesn't have an erection, so I want to get him one. Damn it, what the hell is wrong with everybody?
That's the fifth story we've been kicked out of. Why is it so hard to get an erection?
I just want an erection so I can give it to my mom.
What?
Oh, where are you gonna go, kid? You gonna see your little girlfriend again? Dude, you spend way too much time with that girl. Oh my god, they killed Kenny! Ew, bastards! What the hell happened to him? He just ignited.
What happened?
I saw it from across the street. He just caught on fire.
Okay, people, stand back. Give the little burn boy the breathing room.
I've heard about this. This is spontaneous combustion, but it usually only happens to fat people near open flames.
Is it contagious?
Am I going to spontaneous like the bus?
I hope nothing happens to me.
This is very scary.
The people are panicking about spontaneous combustion. That's why I've assembled this crack team of scientists to find out the cause of the phenomenon. You are the best scientific mind South Park has to offer.
Mayor, I'm a geologist.
Right.
Well, I don't study human biology. I study the Earth.
Look, you're the only scientist that lives in this town. You have to find an answer before more people combust. You do that, and you'll be the most beloved man in South Park.
Randy!
Wow.
Marsh, I'm not asking you, I'm telling you. Find the cause of spontaneous combustion or else.
Or else what?
Exactly.
Dude, he looks so peaceful without his little orange coat on.
Yeah.
The Lord giveth and the Lord taketh away. Sometimes the giveth seems a little disproportionate to the taketh. There seems to be a lot more taketh-ing going on, but there it is. Perhaps if more of you attended church on Sundays, the Lord would not have felt it necessary to punish us by taketh-ing this little boy.
Oh, here comes the guilt trip again.
Now let us pray. Lord, throw him off Neil Smith, the free agency.
Welcome into
the Yanks Baseball Show. Bring home another Super Bowl championship. And once again, bathe in the glory of your life. Amen.
Let's go.
Hello again, everybody. Welcome into the Yanks Baseball Show.
short.
Boys, I haven't seen you in church lately.
Well, I'm Jewish.
You're not too Jewish to worship Jesus, are you?
I guess not.
Good. Boys, how would you like to perform the Stations of the Cross this Friday night?
The what?
It's like a skit, where you reenact the death and glorious resurrection of Jesus Christ.
Hey, resurrection! That's what my dad needs!
Huh?
We'll do it! We'll do it!
Wonderful. Here's a book on how to perform it. Don't let me down, boys.
Dude, this is great! You know all the Stations of the
Cross. Is that your computer?
I don't know, dude. I'm gonna have to go look in the Bible.
Good night, Jerry.
How come people's not watching my chat?
Oh my god, another one! Helen, no! What happened?
God must be very angry with us. But why? How have we angered you, Lord?
Well, let's see. If they combust, no. Could be from no.
Dad, where's our Bible?
Not now, Stan. I have to find out what causes spontaneous combustion, or else.
Or else what?
Exactly.
What?
Right.
Where's our Bible?
It's in the attic with the old LPs. Boys, did you notice anything strange about Kenny in the weeks leading up to his combustion? Or what did he spend his time doing?
He was always with his new girlfriend.
New girlfriend?
Yeah, he started seeing this girl and he spent time on the bus to go visit her. What does that have to do with his death?
Maybe nothing. Maybe everything.
Well, we're gonna go work on getting Kyle's dad an erection.
Yes, yes, of course. I've got work to do. What?
Let's see, Jesus got crucified, then he died, and 3 days later he had a direction. Hey, there's 14 Stations of the Cross. Costumes out of sheets.
This is gonna be fun. I gotta be Jesus. You're too fat to be Jesus. Oh, either I'm Jesus, or I'll screw you, Dad. I'm going home. You're such a fat baby. Well, I guess you guys can do the Stations of the Cross by yourself.
Lost the lead.
Alright, you can be Jesus, you talk.
Alright, let's try it again. Kate was standing in here. Stan, Kyle, and Cartman were walking around him. Okay. Do you feel hot?
No.
Damn it, how come you're not combusting?
Come on, Randy. You said we were gonna drink beer and watch the fight. Another one combusted.
No. Has she been doing anything odd?
No, she was just on her way to her new boyfriend's house.
Boyfriend?
This is stupid. Screw you guys. I'm going home.
No, I think I might have it.
Well, well, well. A lot of you came to church. Looks like we're all a little nervous about this spontaneous combustion thing, huh?
Yeah.
Well, on this blessed Friday, let us give thanks for stuff and things. Lord, is it so much to ask that you want let us suddenly burst into flame for no apparent reason? I mean, come on. Amen. And now, some of our darling local children are going to perform the Stations of the Cross.
Station 1. Jesus is condemned to death by Pilate.
What douche?
You can do what you will, but I am... Station 2. Jesus takes his cross. Oh man, this is totally weak.
Why is it anti-gravity here?
He knows him.
Something weird's going on.
I don't know you, dude. Peter, weak. Peter lame. But I'm Jesus, so I forgive you, I guess.
Mayor,
I have it. I found out why people spontaneously combust.
Why?
That's too complicated to... Call a town meeting tomorrow.
Okay. If you're right about this, Marsh, you're going to be the most popular man in South Park.
Randy!
We love you, Randy.
Make love to me, Randy. Please.
Wow.
Schmuck.
Station 11. Jesus is nailed to the cross. This has gone from weak to super weak. Things cannot get any more weak for me. Then a crown of thorns was placed on Jesus' head, and Jesus was all like, thanks. Well, this sucks that I have to die, but if I die, everyone's sins will be forgiven. So I guess it's cool.
Heavy ammo on the way.
And then Jesus was led away to Mount Sinai, where he died and has a resurrection 3 days later. Hi, Mom.
Thank you, boys. Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Yeah, I told you I'd be a sweet Jesus, you guys. At least the real Jesus didn't weigh 400 pounds. I'd be around the
swimming Yeah, that looks pretty good.
Okay, cool. See you, Carmen.
Hey, wait, where the hell are you going?
I don't know. I'm going home, I guess.
Yeah, me too.
Well, get me down from here.
Carmen, how stupid are you? Didn't you read the Bible? We have to leave you up there until you die, and then you come back to life in 3 days.
What?
Yeah, dummy, you have to get an erection.
Then I can give it to my dad.
I don't want to be Jesus anymore. Don't leave me here, you guys!
You keep near me. Oh, oh. Behind you. Thank you.
South Park will be required to fart on a regular basis to ensure that nobody else spontaneously explodes.
Randy,
we love you, Randy. Make love to me, Randy.
Thank you for showing me otherwise. Yeah, trick ass. Yeah, thanks.
It's okay. I'll just call some 20-year-old and have him come over.
What?
I'm just kidding.
Kidding? Well, that's not funny. That hurt my feelings.
Why?
Why?
Kyle!
Don't worry, you guys. I'm getting an erection as we speak.
Huh?
Well, actually, Carmen's getting an erection, but then we're gonna give it to you. So, back up!
We have a very strange little... Gerald.
One of the keys to making it in television is having a catchphrase.
Hello, Newman.
Don't make me angry.
A catchphrase?
You wouldn't like me when I'm angry.
I am going to hurry up.
Cool. I'm listening.
Excuse me?
Hold up, doctor!
Good evening, everybody.
No!
Marsha!
The truth is out there.
Live long and prosper.
No, thank you very much.
I love it when a plan comes together.
Still not dead. You guys, my mom is totally worried about me. You better let me down.
She's not worried about you.
Yes, she is. I've been hearing her all day. Listen. Listen.
Eric. Eric, where are you? I miss you very much.
That's not your mom calling.
Yes, it is, you guys. And seriously, this is Eric's mom and I want to hear me there.
How stupid do you think we are? Now you die on that cross and get off the record before I kick your ass.
Hey, guys. It's too hot on you. I can't do this.
He is right. It has been getting really hot lately.
Yeah, I noticed that too. Let's go get some ice cold lemonade.
Hey, yeah. Oh, god damn it. You guys want to hear my I Hate Standing Kyle song? I hate Standing Kyle. I said I hate Standing Kyle.
Oh my god, it's burning up in here. Can't we crank the AC up some more?
It's already on full.
You wanted to see me, Mayor?
Yes, Marsh. We have a new problem, and I think only you can solve it.
I suspect you're talking about the dramatic heat wave.
Yes, the temperature is steadily rising every day. I want you to find out why.
Mayor, I think I'm a little overqualified for this. My scientific mind is best used on global problems.
All right, name your price.
10,000. I have to protect my talent.
Done. Just find out what's happening.
Don't worry, Mayor. I'll find the cause. Or else. Or else what? Exactly.
Children,
what the hell are you doing?
Just get me down from here. Oh, finally, my arms are killing me.
You children shouldn't be out crucifying yourselves in this heat.
Sweet. Now I need to go kill those guys.
Eric, I have to tell you something, and it's really going to bum you out.
What?
It's going to really piss you off.
What?
This is just a dream. You're still up on that cross.
Oh, damn it!
You love cheesy poops and weed, and eat cheesy poops, weed, beer.
Dad, where's the phone book?
But now, Stanley, without my scientific genius, the town is doomed. Let's see now. When exactly did the temperature start to go up?
Our topic tonight is the rising temperatures in South Park. Let's go to the phones. Caller, you're on the air.
Yeah, Jesus. How long did I get resurrected?
Stan?
Like it's global warming.
Oh.
Do you have an...
You're falling behind.
Thank you, caller. Well, let's go to our first... Mephisto, thanks for coming. You claim you're the cause of global warming in South Park.
I most certainly do. The cause of global warming is Randy Marsh. It was Marsh's theory on spontaneous combustion that told everyone to fart all they want. Now all the methane from all those farts has ripped a hole in our ozone layer. We're all doomed to die.
Oh, crap.
We won't answer.
You killed us all.
Someone's gotta pay.
It's out of control.
Boy, they're really pissed.
Well, they're right. We should have known that all that methane could adversely affect the atmosphere.
Well, let's go talk to them. Stick by me.
Hey, you killed them all!
Oh, no, fire's under there!
Oh my god, what's going on?
Now we either hold in our farts and spontaneously combust, or we let our farts out and kill our entire planet. Well, I, for one, am not farting anymore.
I'll try to find a solution.
We don't want your solutions, phony.
Give me that.
Yeah!
Damn you, Marsh, get out of town.
You fraud.
Mr. Kirsten, help me. I do not know you, sir.
Up yours.
Sorry.
continues to deplete as others refuse to hold in their farts for fear of combustion. As we all know, the cause for all of this is Randy Marsh, the son of a bitch who calls himself a scientist. We caught up with Mr. Marsh earlier today, and he had this to say.
I don't know what to say.
What an asshole. I hate that guy, and so do
Heavy
you. And now on to the weather. It's fucking hot, thanks to Randy Marsh, son of a bitch.
These good people are pissed. I know, huh? Where's your dad? I'm the dad of the citizen, and I don't know what to do. Well, you have to help him, just like I have to help my dad.
Heavy ammo available.
Still more of that funny wave caused by Randy Marsh. A giant glacier is melting above South Park, and the entire town is doomed. And now these messages.
Having a hard time with male potency? Well, I don't. I'm Bob Dole. What's wrong with you? Christ, I'm Bob Dole, and I can get it up.
Are you Nyla?
Yes.
We want to see Randy Marsh.
Why?
He gave us skin cancer.
Yeah, he put that hole in the ozone, and now he's got skin cancer all over our fat bodies. Look.
What are you doing, Dad?
Stanley, I think it's best you have a towel from now on. His dad is better than me.
No, he's not. He can't even get an erection.
Really?
Dad, you've got to work. People are dying, Dad. You got
to... Not me. Just, I'm a hack. Even if I found a... Those people still all hate me.
That doesn't matter. I learned something from the Stations of the Cross.
What?
First Jesus was all like, why me? And he was all pissed off and stuff. But then he saw that what mattered most was everybody else. So he stopped thinking about his own misery and did what had to be done. Right as Jesus was dying, he raised his hand and said, the needs of the many outweigh the needs of the few.
You're right, Stanley. You're absolutely right. Hey, that Bible sounds like kind of a good book.
It ain't bad. You should try reading it sometime. That was Star Trek again. The many outweigh the needs of the few? That was Rathacon. Oh, well, Bible Rathacon was different.
All right, now let's get to work.
First time I got a melee kill.
Yeah.
only for mature audiences. Your discretion advised.
We've almost won.
My full name is Jason Alexander Lopez. So a lot of people will save me in their phone as George Costanza.
George! George Costanza!
Seinfeld on Hulu is an amazing thing. And I can watch it now and still laugh at the same jokes that I laughed at years ago when I first watched it. Some of my friends that I met through watching the show and loving the show are now some of the closest people that I have in my life. Seinfeld lives in every aspect of my life. I love it.
Defeat is not surrender, Guardian.
I'm going down south, I'm gonna have myself time.
Deadly faces everywhere, humble folks without temptation.
Going down south, I'm gonna leave my woes behind.
And my parking garage, people spouting hardy neighbors.
And on up south, I'm gonna see if I can't unwind.
Oh, thank God, a better weapon.
Mom, please, can we just leave?
You have to see the eye doctor, Harry.
But I hate the eye doctor. He always makes fun of me for being fat.
You're not fat. You're big boned.
That's what I told him, but he doesn't listen to reason.
Eric Cartman.
Wig.
Hello, Eric.
Hi, Dr. Lodge.
How's my little piggy today?
Hey, don't call me a little piggy.
I just say that because you're my little buddy.
I'm just here for an exam, all right? Keep the fat jokes to yourself.
Hop up on the chair. Don't break it now.
God damn it.
Just kidding. Let's see how your eyes are doing. All you have to do is read the letters. Can you see the letters?
Yes.
All right, read them out for me.
I am a little piggy.
No, that was just a weird coincidence. I do not know how that happened. I am a little piggy. Wow, what are the odds of that? All right, let's get down to business, shall we?
Gee, that's a good idea. My mom isn't paying you to be a comedian.
Let's see. Which is better, one or two? One or two?
They look exactly the same.
Just pick one. Or two.
I don't know, two.
Okay. One or two. One or two.
One.
One or two. One or two.
Yeah, it dropped down, didn't it? Told you, hardcore people are leaving.
I hate you.
Yes, there's obviously a problem with your eyes. I'm going to have to dilate them and run some tests.
I wonder how come Cartman's not in school today.
Yeah, usually when he ditches school, he still shows up for lunch.
Yeah. Oh, here he comes.
Hey, dude.
Whoa, what happened to your eyes, Cartman?
My asshole eye doctor made them all dilated.
Why?
What? I'll tell you why. Because he's a goddamn asshole, and that's about it.
Why do you have to see an eye doctor?
Because my eyes suck. But that doctor likes to torture me, and I have to go back tomorrow. I don't know what I'm gonna do.
Dude, just ask Shep for help. He always knows what to do.
Hey, yeah. Ow. Hey, Shep.
Hello there, children.
Dude, my eyes are seriously screwed up. Shep looks like a skinny little white guy.
It's time for luncheroo.
Where's Shep?
Shep quit.
What?
Chef is gone, so let me introduce myself. I'm your new Mr. Derp.
Mr. Derp?
When I'm in the kitchen, you never know what nutty things are gonna happen. If you like Chef, you're gonna love Mr. Derp. Oh, Derp. Derp. Oh, wasn't that silly, kid?
Why did Chef quit?
Aren't I a great character? My antics go right to the funny bone. Oh, I don't feel so good. Derp.
Could you just hand us some food, please?
Sure, gang. I have yellow stuff or white stuff. Derp.
Can I have a yellow with a side of white? Dude, I hate Mr. Derp.
Yeah, we gotta talk to Chef after school and get him to come back.
I don't know, you guys. That hammer thing was pretty funny.
Shut up, Cartman.
Ow.
Oh, hello there, children.
Chef, what the hell are you doing? We almost starved to death at lunch today.
Oh, didn't they tell you? I quit.
Yeah, but we didn't believe them.
Well, it's true.
But why? Why would you quit?
Children, 3 nights ago, I was at the library checking out some books on Kama Sutra when I met the most amazing woman ever. She knew so much about so many things. She really got me thinking. We eventually came back to my place and really hit it off.
So you made sweet love to her down by the fire?
No, we just sat there all night long and talked.
Talked?
Yeah, she told me all about the power of the goddess and how men had been oppressing women for years and viewing them as sexual objects. And I realized that I had done that myself.
Oh, well, darling little children.
Children, meet my new girlfriend, Veronica.
That's nice. Look, Chef, Carmen's got this eye doctor, see?
girlfriend?
Children, Veronica's moving in with me.
Moving in?
I'm in love.
Love? Oh, you nut.
What the hell is going on?
Veronica spent the whole day sharing her favorite
boys.
Four.
I'm stealing Chef away from you.
But Chef always helps us with our problems. When we have a problem, Chef sings to us and makes
us. Oh, jeez.
She still do that, children. In fact, she's a great singer, too.
What's the problem?
Nailed it.
Sorry, I got your sad part. It's really, really mean.
Oh, I know just the song for you.
Gained the lead.
There's going to be a movie for us. If we can hold on to the night,
we have a chance to find the sunshine.
Let's keep on
this.
Oh,
have you seen the...
Why can't you protect me?
Maybe. Is it possible that we're just jealous because Chef is our friend and now he's paying attention to somebody new? Yeah, so? Bitch, I hate that bitch. Look, we've just got to get Chef home. He won't listen to reason with that hooker around. Let's find out where he's working and go see him there tomorrow. Good idea.
Ow!
We got your test results back, Piggy.
Stop calling it Piggy.
You've got this small stigmatism that's causing all the problems.
They got five!
Piggy, that your eyesight is never going to get better.
Alright. Right now, I'm going to be totally seriously, okay? If you call me Piggy one more time, I'm gonna leap out of this chair and rip your goddamn nuts off with my bare hands!
Well, don't worry. I've got something that's going to make your eyes as good as new.
Oh, dude, super weak. I'm not wearing these. The guys would totally rip on me.
I know. The hardest thing to do is get kids to wear their glasses.
I'm just gonna take them off as soon as I leave.
That's why we have the little stapler.
Ow! Son of a bitch! They said Chef works in one of these buildings. Hey, dudes. Look at Carmen and his stupid glasses. Dude, just take them off. I can't, they're stable to my head. Hey, you guys.
Hello, and welcome to Steinberg and Bergstein. Can I help you?
We want to talk to Chef.
Chef?
He's a big guy with a beard and a chef's hat.
Oh, the black guy.
Huh?
Third cubicle on the left. Hey, aren't you that cute little kid from Jerry Maguire?
Yeah, sure.
Wow, you really got fat.
Hi.
Hello there, children.
Hey, Chef.
Eric, you got glasses.
Chef, you have to dump the bitch.
Huh?
We need you, Chef.
Hey, Chef, we're gonna run down to the office supply store and get some leather holders for our pagers. You wanna come?
You bet.
Chef, this place isn't you.
Children, Veronica showed me that I've been living a very empty life. Meaningless sex is fun for 20 or 30 years, but after that, it starts to get old.
But we don't like her.
Why not?
I don't know. No reason, I guess.
Children, friends get girlfriends all the time. It's something even you would have to face with each other someday.
No way, dude. Please, Chef, I don't know what to do about my stupid glasses.
That's easy. Get some laser corrective surgery. That's what I did.
Hey, laser corrective surgery. Thanks, Chef.
You see? Everything's gonna be fine. Now, how about I meet you boys after work and we can play ball?
Okay. Chef should be here any minute. Dude, he bailed on us. I can't believe it. Come on, we're going to his house.
Hello there, children.
All right, mister. You better have a good explanation why you didn't show up to play ball.
Oh, children, I'm sorry. I forgot.
You forgot?
No! God damn it!
Well, we got something to tell you about Veronica, Chef.
They got more!
Man, we're having a good time here, man.
Children, I've got some great news for you. Veronica and I are getting married.
Oh, no.
My whole family's coming in for the wedding, and I want you boys to come, too.
This is so wonderful. Let's sing. There's got to be a morning after.
If we can hold on to the night, we have a chance to find the sunshine.
One of the keys to making it in television is having a catchphrase.
Alright,
you wouldn't like me when I'm angry. I'm listening.
Oh. can't play. I need a break from this game. I'm done.